Hare Krishna, Om Namah Shivaya, Namaha Sarva Krishna Paramastu. So today I am reading chapter 1 from Sloka 40 onwards. Already I have said up to 40th in the previous videos. So we can start reading from 40. I will be reading the slokas and then I will be giving the meaning also. Okay. So this is the 40th one. Manushya manuja vyakra sa bilaksha sutan prati lobat pratyupakaraya nanvetan kimna pashyasi. This is, hey lion among men. Manushya manuja vyakra means the lion among the men. King of kings. He was the king of kings. Surada. So the Maharshi is telling king of kings. Man shows affection to their sons with the hope that they would help them in their need. So we are looking after our children with the hope that in future they will look take care of us. But are you not seeing these birds? So don't you see these birds? The sage points out that birds do this action without any expectation. The birds are also looking after their children, but without any expectation. So next stanza. Tadapi mamata varte mohagarte nipatita mahamaya prabhavena samsara sthidikarina. Tadapi mamada means affection, love, affection. Mohagarte nipatita. Mohagarte means the pit. Garte means pit. Due to this affection, people are falling in the pit of attachment. Okay. In spite of that, due to the power of great enchantress, but all these are due to the power of the great enchantress, that is Devi. Man is pushed into the whirlpool of attachment, mamadagarte, and the pit of affection, and observes the rules of human life. So due to the affection and attachment, we are falling into the pit and then we are leading this human life. Okay, so then attachment and affection are binding us. Are the two persons who are working behind our minds. So that is why you all are having such a feeling that you all can't, even though you all have left your kingdom and your families respectively, still you all are thinking about those people only, because now you all are alone. So then this is nothing, as it's not a surprise at all. You are all, this Mahamaya is working behind you, so it's not a big surprise. That's what she is telling them. That is the 41st is over, 42nd. Tanatra vismaya karyo yoga nidra jagatpade mahamaya hareschaitatya sammohyade jagat means the great enchantress is, but the yogic sleep of Mahavishnu. When Mahavishnu is sleeping, there is a yogic, it's known as yoga nidra. So that time there is a Mahamaya, that is a Devi, that is getting enchant, that is the enchantress who is enchanting all our minds. The Lord of the universe, the enchantress enchants the entire world, and so you need not wonder what about your reaction. So this enchantress, this Devi is working on you all, so then you don't have to worry about your mental state. Devas do not sleep, but take away their senses from happenings. Devas, they do not sleep, but take away the senses from all these happenings. No, this, what are the worldly things? They don't get attached to these worldly things. They don't sleep and they don't keep attachment. They do their duty. There's no attachment. Just do your duty for the sake of God. No, don't keep attachment. That is the thing they are saying, and forget about the world. This is yogic sleep. Next, 43. Jnaninam api chetamsi devi bhagavadihi sa balada krukshya mohaya mahamaya prayachadi. The meaning is that the famous Mahamaya, great enchantress who is personification of all riches, draws the mind of even those who have special knowledge. special knowledge people also she draws their attention and make them behave with baser instinct of affection. When she can draw the instincts of those blessed with special knowledge, she can do it easily in the case of people like you. So then those people who have controlled mind, yogic people, their enchantress is working on in their minds and they are getting attachment, feelings of attachment and love and affection and all. So then this attachment and affection in the mind of you people is not a big thing. It is even binding highly educated people, highly spiritual people also. This Devi is working on them and they are also falling into the pit of affection and attachment. So this is not a big thing. So that's what this Maharshi is telling and giving them. This is the 42nd. Taya visrujyate vishwam trilokyam sacharacharam saisha prasanna varada nrunam bhavati muktaye. Meaning is that she creates the three worlds with immovable and immovable things. The Devi is creating the whole world. And though she is the cause of this attachment, she is the cause of all this attachment. If she becomes pleased, she grants salvation to human beings. But when we please this Devi, she is giving you a salvation, that is self-realization, that is moksha. Okay, she is the person who is giving us the feeling of attachment and love and affection, everything. That's a good feeling, but for us the journey of our soul, this attachment will keep us binding. We will have this binding, we will be binded with our family and we will not progress in our spiritual life. So only if you cut the thread of attachment and affection, you have to do your duty still without all these things and without thinking of the rewards. You have to do your duty and keep your mind perfectly clean without any ego attachment, delusion, everything. Okay, the 45th one. Savidya parama mukter hedu bhuta sanatane samsara bandha hedushcha shaiva sarveshwareshwari. She is the greatest knowledge, which is the cause of salvation. Okay, and she also is the ignorance that leads to attachment. Because of ignorance, this attachment is coming. But we people think that is the actual knowledge. Ignorance, this actually in spiritual world, it is ignorance. Attachment is ignorance with the mundane world. Okay. Also, she is the goddess of all gods. Sarveshwareshwari means goddess of all the gods. So, I'll read it once. But she is the greatest knowledge, which is the cause of salvation. And she is also the ignorance that leads to attachment with this mundane world. Also, she is the goddess of all gods. So, then the Raja is saying, hearing all these things, Raja is saying to this Rishi, Bhagavan ka hi sa devi mahamayeti yam bhavan. Braveti kadamutpanna sa karmaschyascha kim dvija. The king is telling, hey godly person, who is this holy Devi? Who is this Mahamaya who was mentioned by you as the great enchantress? Who is she? What is her form? Everything. Yat prabhava cha sa devi yat swarupa yadutbhava tat sarvam srotumichami. Tvatho bravi dhamvara. 47th one. Hey, one of the chiefs among those who know Brahma, that is ultimate truth. What are the powers of that holy Devi? What are her powers? Who is this Brahma? How does she look like? And where from was she born? Be pleased to tell me all this. I want to know about all the details about this Devi, this enchantress, whom you have given us, described to us, okay? Vishruvaja. Nithyaiva sa jagat murti staya sarvamidham tatham tathapita samudpathir badhuda sruyatham mama. 48 and the sage one. That holy Devi who is the form of the universe is permanent. So, and she has created this whole world. She is the permanent feature. She is the permanency of this universe. And she has created this whole world. Okay, Devanam karya siddhyartham avirbhavati sayatha utpanneti tada loge sanityapyadi vidhiyate. See, though that holy Devi exists permanently whenever she appears before in this world for helping Devas, it is told that she is born at that time. So she is the permanent figure. She is permanently present in this universe, as this universe. And whenever she comes, takes out a form of her own in order to help Devas, then it is told that she has taken her avatar, or she has appeared, born. But actually it is not being born, she is only taking avatars. Like Vishnu took 10 avatars, this Devi is also taken avatars. So the 50th one, Yoga Nidram Yada Vishnur Jagatya Karana Vikrutate Asthirya Shema Bhajat Kalpante Bhagavan Prabhu. See, and other next verse, Tata Dvasvara So Ghorav Vikyato Madukhaidabo Vishnukarna Malot Bhuto Hantum Brahma Mudyutado. Means the meaning is that when great Lord Vishnu entered into his yogic slumber on the bed of Shesha, the great snake which was lying over the single ocean, everything has turned. This whole Brahmanda had the pralaya had taken place, and the whole Brahma, everything was lost, and only the only thing that survived is that Sheshanaga, which was who is the bed of Mahavishnu. So, and a single ocean with Shesha, on which bed Mahavishnu is sitting, is sleeping. The earth and sea transformed thus at the end of the world deluge out of the earwax of Vishnu. So at that time, what's happening is that out of the earwax of Vishnu, two famous and terrible asuras called Madhu and Kaidaba rose with an intention of troubling Brahma. Shesha also indicates that it is the only thing remaining after the deluge. So then when Vishnu was sleeping on this bed, some earwax from his ears fell down. So then that has taken the form of two great asuras, that is the Madhu and the Kaidaba, and they were running to kill this Brahma, who was born out of the lotus from the navel of Mahavishnu. So I have finished up to 51. So next day I will be starting with the reading of 62. 52. Thank you.